Now the next topic is micropropagation. The micropropagation means the production of plants from very small plant part, tissue or cell grown aseptically in a test tube or a container under a controlled nutritional environment and aseptic condition. The micropropagation is carried out in a total controlled condition, that is in lab. How the micropropagation is differ from the vegetative propagation? For the micropropagation require a very small plant part, that is explant is used as a starting material. The explant are maintained in a small containers having well defined culture medium. The culture medium, the component of culture medium is a different that is a basic culture medium is it's required nutrient medium like potassium, NPK, then some growth regulators that is cytokinin and auxins, etc. The highly aseptic conditions are required. A large propagating material is produced a very short times. That means through the micropropagation we can produce a large number of plants within a short time. The various application of micropropagation are the rapid rate of multiplication of a plants clonally, then the production of disease free and disease resistant plants. Through the micropropagation we are produce virus free plants through the meristem culture. Then induction of mutant and selection of mutants. Then the production of haploids through anther culture. Wide hybridization through excised embryo or ovule culture. Somatic hybrids and cybrids through protoplast fusion. Then transformation through uptake of foreign genome and cryopreservation of germplasm types. Means the micropropagation, through the micropropagation we can produce a high quality of plants. Some advantages of micropropagation. Through the micropropagation we can produce large number of plants within a short time and produce disease free plants. Through the clonal propagation of parental stock for the hybrid production, seed production, year round nursery production. Then useful propagation of dioecious plants. Through the micropropagation we can produce a dioecious plant. Then the breeding cycle is reduces. In general the vegetative propagation the breeding cycle is long as compared to micropropagation. Then the useful in hard to propagate plant spaces. Germplasm can be preserved through the micropropagation. Some disadvantages of micropropagation. It is an expensive and sophisticated facilities. Trained personnel and specialized techniques are required. It's require high cost initial, or the initial cost is more. Then high cost of production results for expensive facilities and high labor inputs. Contamination or the insect infestation can cause high losses in a short time. Then high level of somatic variation, then poor establishment of plant slates in the field. Sometimes the propagated plants through the micropropagation cannot withstand in field condition. So this is the disadvantages of micropropagation. Then the some principles and practices of micropropagation. Then totipotency and plant regeneration. The term totipotency is coined by the German plant physiologist Haverland in 1902. This is achieved by exercising the explants and placing in on culture medium. In the culture medium, which involves the following consecutive events: the differentiation of source, tissue or organ, as a result of which all physiological mechanism active in the cell, which leads to cell division. Then the active cell division in the entire cut surface of a explant, resulting proliferation of the callus tissue. Then the proliferation, that means the fast growth of plant. Then organization of the defined meristem, resulting in the formation of shoot or root meristem or both. Regeneration and differentiation of new organ through the organogenesis or the somatic embryogenesis. This is the principles of माइक्रो प्रोपेगेशन, फर्स्ट एक्सिलरी बर्ड प्रोलिफरेशन. इट कंसिडर्ड एज अ कन्वीनियंट रूट फॉर द माइक्रो प्रोपेगेशन बिकॉज इट डज नॉट इंक्लूड अ कैलस. इन द एक्सिलरी बर्ड प्रोलिफरेशन वी यूज अ शूट टिप्स और इवन अ स्मॉलर अपाइकल मेरिस्टम आर कल्चर्ड इन अ एप्रोप्रिएट कल्चर मीडियम कंटेनिंग हायर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ साइटोकाइनिन. इन द एक्सिलरी बर्ड प्रोलिफरेशन द एक्सप्लांट इज यूज एज अ शूट टिप और द स्मॉल अपाइकल मेरिस्टेम. देन द एक्सिलरी बर्ड इज अ ग्रो एक्सटेंसिवली. प्रोलिफरेशन ऑफ मेनी साइट्स शूट्स विच आर लेटर द सेपरेटेड फॉर द फर्दर कल्चर. सेकेंड टर्म ऑर्गेनोजेनेसिस. ऑर्गेनोजेनेसिस मीन्स द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ऑर्गन्स. ऑर्गेनोजेनेसिस फ्रॉम एक्सप्लांट्स results in the formation of both shoot and root. Generally, shoots are formed first then root. In organogenesis, shoots are formed first then root. In a field condition, first form root then shoots. In a generation, the regeneration of other organs occur later on, either in the same media or after the subculturing in another medium, supplemented with different concentration of salt under different environmental conditions. Then somatic embryogenesis. Somatic embryogenesis is a different from organogenesis, that is the regeneration and organization are bipolar. That means the shoot and root meristem in the explant are formed simultaneously from the pre-embryonic masses. In organogenesis we see first form shoot then root. In somatic embryogenesis, simultaneous formation of shoot and root. The differentiation and organization of somatic embryogenesis, usually two stages culture is involved. First, induction of pre-embryonic masses, which is usually favored by 2,4-D or other auxins. That means the first induction, that is the first culture medium or the nutrient is 2,4-D and other auxins. Then second, by the transfer of the pre-embryonic masses to the differentiated medium in which the somatic embryos fully differentiated into organs. Then the stages of micropropagation. In a micropropagation, it is the integrated process in which cell, tissue or the organs of selected plants are isolated, surface sterilized and incubated in a growth promoting sterile medium and environment to produce a large number of plants. The different stages of micropropagation. In micropropagation, there are four stages of micropropagation. First number, zero stage, that is called a zero stage, the selection of mother plants for the explant isolation. First criteria for a selection of mother plants. The mother plants from which explant has to be excised should be a certified and true to type representative of the desired species or the cultivars. It should be healthy and free from insect pests and diseases. Then it should be quite vigorous. The first stage of micropropagation is explant establishment in a culture. During this stage, the explant is cultured in a suitable culture medium, preferably agar-based media, for the tissue activation and multiplication. In micropropagation, we use agar medium for the tissue activation and multiplication. The first stage is establishment of explant. Second stage is multiplication and proliferation of explants. In this stage, the repeated subculture is done to encourage more proliferation, which largely depends upon the combination of growth regulators. The duration of this stage is unlimited and largely depend on the choice of propagator. Proliferation, that means the fast growth of plants. Second, third stage, plant establishment and rooting. In this stage, the selected plants are forced for the root formation, which can be achieved by media modification and modifying the concentration of growth regulators. That is, the concentration of cytokinin and sugars are reduced, and the concentration of auxins and light intensity is in the laboratory is increased to start with photosynthesis and other physiological activities. That means in a third stages we are change the concentration of growth regulators, that is cytokinin, the sugar is reduced and auxin and light intensity is increased. In a field condition for the shoot formation we are use the auxins, and for the root formation or the cell division for cytokinin. The growth regulator, role of growth regulator is reverse or the contrast in micropropagation. Stage number 4 is acclimatization or hardening. The plantlets developed in the culture tube are acclimatized to specific environment having a high humidity, a low light level and constant temperature. Acclimatization, that means the survival of a plant in a new environment, that is called as acclimatization. Besides, the root development in vitro are hairless and hence delicate, the requiring care during transfer from culture medium. To have a better survival, the rate of plantlets may be transferred to container kept in a mist chamber where the relative humidity is maintained at higher order. Once the growth is seen, the plantlets may be slowly transferred to outside by exposing to increased light intensity in the stages. That means the plantlets are transferred to shade condition or the second condition, that is hardening, that called as hardening. In that condition the humidity is reduced and intensity is light intensity is increased. This is the stages of micropropagation. First stage, establishment of plants. The shoots are established in a culture 2 to 3 months. Then the cycle development of small cluster of shoots. The second stage, shoot multiplication. It's required 2 months. Cycle small clumps of shoot increase in 2 months. Then cycle 3, normal increase in 2 months. The shoot development required for 2 months. Three stage rooting, in vitro rooted in culture for 1 month, in ex vitro rooted directly in a soil 1 to 2 months. That means the third stage we can plant the explant can be planted directly in a field or in the shade condition. Then stage number 4, acclimatization. The plants established in individual cells 3 to 4 weeks under the mist. The total period of growth in a cells is 3 months. Then hardening of tissue culture plants. Once plants are well rooted, they must be acclimatized to the greenhouse environment. In vitro rooted plants are removed from the culture vessels and the agar is washed away completely to remove the potential source of contamination. The plantlets are transplanted into the standard pasteurized rooting or the soil mixture in a small pots or the cells in a more or less conventional manner initially. Microplants should be protected from desiccation in a shaded high humidity or under mist or the fog. Several days may be required for new functional root to form. That means the plantlets may be transferred to greenhouse. Then after transferring of plantlets to greenhouse, the rooting media or the media should be changed from the agar media to soil media or the any other media. In that condition the humidity and temperature is changed. That is, humidity is reduced as compared to lab condition and light intensity is increased. For the root formation required several days. Next, hardening of a plant. Plantlet should be gradually exposed to lower relative humidity and higher light intensity. Any dormancy or the resting condition that develop may be to be overcome as a part of the establishment process. The condition help the plantlets in getting acclimatized to natural condition, which would help them in getting established in the field easily. this process, that is hardening, is essential for the plantlets can be established or the survive in a field condition. Some different cultural techniques and medium of micropropagation. There are different cultural techniques, for example, such as the meristem culture, callus culture, shoot bud regeneration, somatic embryogenesis, oil culture, embryo culture, anther culture, protoplast culture are employed in a micropropagation. In that one, first culture technique is meristem culture. Meristem culture involves culture of both shoot tips and axillary buds. That means the explant of the culture medium is meristem or the shoot tips or axillary buds. The use of small shoot tips comprising of all apical dome with one or two leaf primordia 0.1 to 0.5 mm is the basis for the technique known as a meristem tip culture. This is term given by the Morell in the 1950. The meristem tip culture is known being routinely used mainly in the horticultural crops for the elimination of virus from the infected material. The viruses apparently either does not easily invade or the rapidly multiply in the young meristem tissue. That means the totally free or the free virus free plants can be produced through meristem culture. Second culture, callus culture. A piece of sterile plant tissue with living cells is transferred to the culture medium to induce callus proliferation. Subculturing is then done onto the medium with the without altered growth regulator concentration, ultimately resulting in the induction of adventitious organs or the embryos. That means the living cells are used for the callus culture. Then cell culture, the cell are maintained in a suspension culture so as to produce free cells, are then subculture to regenerate complete plant from the single cell. That means in a cell culture, the subculture or the complete subculture for a regeneration of complete plants from the single cell. In a callus culture, we cannot alter the growth regulator concentration or the subculture. This technique is now useful in induce variability in a plant cells and to select desirable cell variants to regenerate complete plants from these variants. Then embryo culture, it involves aseptic excision of the embryo and its transfer to suitable medium for the development of under the optimum culture condition. After the embryo has grown into the plantlets in a vitro, it is transferred to sterile soil or vermiculite and grown to the maturity in a greenhouse. That means the embryo is developed on a aseptic condition. After that, the embryo is grown onto the plantlets in vitro condition. It is transferred to sterile soil or vermiculite for the maturity to grown to the maturity in a greenhouse. This technique is useful in the production of intergeneric and interspecific hybrid which could not be otherwise accomplished and also grown overcoming embryo abortion. Through the embryo culture, we can produce interspecific and intergeneric hybrid and also can overcome the embryo abortion problem. Then protoplast culture. From the different sources protoplast, the plant without any rigid cellulose wall but with plasma membrane only allowed to fuse to form a somatic hybrid, that is called as a protoplast, are cultured in a suitable media to regenerate the cell wall and again culture in a suitable medium for the differentiation and morphogenesis. Then anther culture. The anther culture is the considerable value to breeders as it possible to produce haploid plants which reveal recessive alleles. Through the anther culture, we can produce haploid plants can use for the production of homozygous diploids, and thus avoiding the generation of inbreeding. In anther culture, it has been used in a pelargonium species to eliminate virus, in a lignin species to produce haploid plants, and in a gerbera to obtain different flower color. Through the anther culture, we can produce haploid plant. Somatic embryogenesis. The greatest potential for the clonal multiplication is through somatic embryogenesis, where technically a single isolated cell can produce first an embryo, then complete plant, called as somatic embryogenesis. We can produce a, through the somatic embryogenesis, single isolated cell can produce a first embryo and then complete plant. The somatic embryogenesis and plantlet regeneration has been reported in a various species of horticulture plants by using midrib, leaf, stem, callus on modified MS basal medium, supplemented with 1 to 2 milligrams per liter, other 240 and 0.25 to 0.50 milligrams of IBA or kinetine. The basic component of culture medium. The basic component of nutrient media are inorganic salts, carbohydrates, vitamins, growth regulators, agar for the solid medium and the water. Other components including organic nitrogenous compound, organic acid and complex substances can be imported. Important but are optional. For the media preparation or the containing of media, the inorganic nutrients required for in a macronutrients amounts are macro amounts are NPK, calcium, sulfur and magnesium. The essential micronutrients required in micromolar concentration including ferrous, manganese, zinc, boron, copper and molybdenum. Then the standard carbon source is a sucrose and glucose at a concentration of 2 to 3%. The pH of culture medium is an important factor for the maintenance of growth culture, growth of cultured plant tissues. For the culture plant tissues, for the culture medium, the pH is required. Acidic pH is an initial pH is 5.5 to 5.8 optimum. Both liquid and solid form of culture medium are useful for the initiation and proliferation of callus tissue and initial organogenesis, but for the further growth of organs, solid medium is essential. This all about micropropagation. Some questions related to micropropagation. So first, what is meant by micropropagation? Second, which is different stages of micropropagation? Which type of nutrient required for preparation of culture media? Then what is the principle of micropropagation and which is the different culture techniques of micropropagation? Thank you.